Imagine a future where wars are no longer fought with firepower alone, but with silent, surgical precision. And I'm not talking about precision-guided missiles here. Why sink a ship when you can render it powerless? Meet the Propulsion Disabler, or PD, a revolutionary weapon concept that could change the face of modern naval warfare. Theorized by Captain Bradford Dismukes, the small yet devastating device could take the form of a mine, an underwater drone, or a lightweight torpedo. Its mission is to destroy a ship's external propulsion system, rudders and propellers, leaving it dead in the water. No movement means no mission. Cargo ships can't deliver their goods, and warships not only lose their lethality against targets beyond the range of their onboard weapons, but they also turn into stationary targets. Now, let me be clear. In unclassified domains, this weapon does not yet exist. Well, except for the Chinese media frequently teasing new underwater technologies, and one specific mention by a Wired article that the CIA possessed such a weapon system back in 2018. But how can stopping an enemy warship be more advantageous than destroying it? Why would propulsion disablers be almost undetectable? What makes these devices a strategic weapon? And why the United States Navy's most criticized ships might be the only vessel immune to such attacks? It's not what you think. Technology moves really fast. Just a few years ago, FPV drones with explosives didn't exist. Now they dominate the Russo-Ukrainian war. Propulsion disablers could be next, and for good reasons, because they can take many forms. For example, even an FPV drone could become a propulsion disabler, minus the FPV part, since signals don't travel underwater. Drones are no longer just airborne. They can also move underwater, a technology that's already possessed by both China and the United States. Recently, China unveiled a drone that launches from a submerged submarine, loops between the sky and the water, and returns to base. What's quite unique is that these drones can mimic fish, sharks, or other sea creatures, making PDs nearly undetectable, which makes them even harder to counter. A propulsion disabler could also be in the form of a mini torpedo, launched from a submarine or an underwater drone mothership. Full-size torpedoes need to carry a large quantity of explosives in order to sink a vessel, which makes them massive, up to 20 feet long, and therefore easier to detect. In contrast, lightweight torpedoes are significantly smaller since they need less explosives to achieve their task. This means that not only they're more difficult to detect, but they're also cheaper to produce, making them deployable in large quantities. Alternatively, PDs could function as smart, maneuverable underwater mines. That said, they might fall into the category of unmanned underwater vehicles, deployed in vast numbers, sitting silently waiting for their targets. But even more important than their size and form is their intelligence. Propulsion disablers won't just attack blindly. They'll be smart, capable of distinguishing friend from foe, identifying ship types, and selecting their targets with precision. Armed with a database of sonic signatures, PDs will recognize both naval and civilian vessels, enabling them to strike only when needed. And they won't act alone. These weapons will swarm, overwhelming countermeasures and coordinating attacks on multi-screw ships. One may not be a threat, but dozens, that could be unstoppable. Another advantage of PDs would be their launch platform, which could be from air, surface, or underwater. Submarines and massive autonomous platforms like the Boeing Orca could deploy them silently. Motherships or underwater mine hubs could unleash swarms of PDs in key locations. Against civilian vessels, aircraft could rapidly seed entire zones, while missiles could scatter PDs deep into enemy waters. Even torpedoes could deliver clusters of miniaturized PDs into strategic choke points. To significantly extend its range, a propulsion disabler could combine a hybrid propulsion system with underwater glider technology. Unlike traditional systems, underwater gliders use variable buoyancy for propulsion, eliminating the need for propellers or thrusters. Their wings generate forward motion as they ascend and descend, enabling an impressive range of 3,100 miles and depth of up to 6.8 miles. Some can dive up to 80 times per mission, with deployments lasting over 200 days, all for a price tag of about $100,000. Speaking of cost, propulsion disablers need to be really inexpensive. For context, a Mark 48 torpedo costs $4.2 million, a Harpoon missile costs $1.4 million, and the Air Force's Quicksink Seeker is expected to drop to a per-unit cost of $50,000 during mass production. PDs must cost even less, which should be feasible, considering that they don't need to sink ships. They just need to stop them. Sinking a ship is a big deal, because regardless of it being a civilian or military vessel, it can lead to a rapid escalation. Contrast that with simply disabling the propellers. It yields a similar effect, but with much less severe consequences. Blowing up an oil tanker, followed by a giant oil spill, would trigger severe political and diplomatic fallout, especially now in the information age. In contrast, disabling the ship and leaving it adrift minimizes the consequences while still enforcing the blockade. Using non-lethal force allows governments to impose their rules more readily and demonstrate the upper hand by taking control of a vessel or forcing the adversary to tow it back without resorting to destruction. This kind of gesture would be highly valuable in information warfare, as well as any ongoing or future diplomatic negotiations. Of course, you could also take control of a cargo ship with the help of a helicopter and a SWAT team. It's just that there are way more ships than there are SWAT teams. In the event of a large-scale global naval blockade, only large quantities of propulsion disablers will be able to accomplish this objective. This can arguably turn PDs into a strategic weapon. In a conflict against major powers like Russia or China, PDs could cut off access to the sea for both civilian and military purposes, pressuring adversaries into negotiations. Disabling a few key vessels can be enough to send a message, forcing others to remain in port, effectively achieving a blockade without the backlash of destruction. Aside from their non-lethal nature, propulsion disablers offer two other advantages: deniability and intelligence gathering. Imagine a United States Navy destroyer passing through China-claimed territory in the South China Sea under the Freedom of Navigation operations. China could disable it with a PD and deny its involvement. This can be an ideal hybrid warfare tactic, forcing the United States to recover the ship while deciding on a response. In a full-scale war, PDs could neutralize enemy ships for intelligence gathering or capturing POWs. Even without direct engagement, they force the enemy to deal with their own stranded vessels. But let's not forget about the littoral combat ships. Yes, the two classes of LCS that have been criticized ad nauseam by everyone on the internet, including us. That said, unlike traditional ships with propellers and rudders, LCS use water jets, blasting 26,000 gallons per second. For a PD to disable one, it would have to fight against that sheer force, making these ships far more difficult to stop, especially that they can move at speeds in excess of 40 knots. Propulsion disablers may seem like the perfect weapon, until you consider the chaos they leave behind. Disabling a ship is one thing, But what happens when that ship starts drifting toward a deadly storm, a reef, or a jagged shoreline? Suddenly, the attacker might be forced into the unexpected role of rescuing the crew or even towing the ship to safety for ethical, political, or legal reasons. But here is the nightmare. What do you do with hundreds of disabled ships adrift, piling up, clogging vital waterways? Blowing them up might be brutal, but at least it doesn't leave a floating scrapyard in its wake. In a political conflict in Taiwan, PDs could be game changers. Thousands of smart propulsion disabling mines could surround the island, ready to deploy at the first sign of a Chinese invasion. The key is to strike only hostile ships, prioritizing minesweepers and amphibious vessels. Even rescue tugs sent to retrieve disabled ships could be taken out, turning reinforcement efforts into a logistical nightmare. China could still blockade Taiwan with aircraft and missiles, but PDs would make an amphibious landing nearly impossible. Of course, if the threat fades, PDs can be recovered and reused at a later time. But do propulsion disablers already exist? Technically, yes, they're called fishing nets. But jokes aside, the CIA has reportedly had at least one propulsion disabling system since 2018. At one point, it was considered for disabling the Venezuelan oil tankers supplying Cuba. But with only one system located in a different hemisphere, the idea was shelved. What kind of system it was, no one knows. It wasn't necessarily a PD drone or a lightweight torpedo. It could have been a high-power microwave weapon, like Boeing's Champ missile, an EMP missile that causes no structural damage but fries the electronics, as seen in this test, shutting down the computers. Or it could have just been a cyber attack exploiting an unknown vulnerability, disabling a ship's navigation, control, or propulsion systems. With all that said, PDs are not invincible. Just as drone minesweepers counter conventional mines, similar systems could neutralize propulsion disablers. Whether PDs become the next big thing or a transformative weapon remains to be seen, but their advantages are undeniable. More importantly, they're not just a tool for geopolitical giants. PDs could become an asymmetric weapon for regional adversaries like Houthis and Iran, cheap, stealthy, and difficult to counter. Western ships may soon face PD attacks in today's gray area conflicts, especially in the Middle East, where military and civilian vessels operate dangerously close to shore. In a world of torpedoes and missiles that can sink ships, who knew? The real game changer could be a weapon that simply makes them stop. Hey there, we are hiring. If you think you're a scriptwriter who can match our caliber of research, or if you're a video editor who can source quality footage like we do, we're looking for you. Click the link below to apply and become part of Not What You Think.